Hi student, today I'd like to show you a very short video, some information about your end-term examination. I think maybe you have already, in this end-term examination, you will have some writing tests, but with your student number, and you must fill the numerical results. For example, you can have such form. At the start, you will have one general line. Let A be the last digit of your student number, and the parameter M equal A plus 1. For example, if you have such student number, so the last digit is 4. So M equal 5, you must provide with this information immediately when you start your work. And on the question later in the end-term test will be depends on M. For example, I take that question from your end-term review. You will have three questions. And you see here, you have one, the same heat equations, but with different data and on depends on M. And for example, when for question, for the first question, I, student. Remember clearly, focus your attention. Below, under each question, you will have one empty space, some empty line. So you must provide your short solution there. And after that, you will have one box, so you can fill numerical results. You must provide your solution. If you don't provide your solution, but you give only the numerical results, even this is right, your score will be reduced. Even your score can be zero for that question. So for this simple question, I, the answer, because we have M equal 5, so you have the initial data. You have this a heat problem with direct labor condition. So you write U S T, you know this is the sum BN exponential K has 61 over 2 and where T sin and S. Now you treat the initial condition. When t equals 0, you have the sum of bn sin ns equal a sin 2s. So you know b2, this is a, and you continue. You can see the full answer, in fact, in your end-term review that I already uploaded, because I took this question exactly from that end-term review. And after that, you write the numerical result. If I don't make mistake, this is 2.6i. Okay, that result I took from your end-term review. And similarly for question II, question III. So remember something, student. In fact, this not something new. This absolutely similar to the example, to the exercises, to the questions in your review, but with your student number. You must write clearly your M. You must use M to solve, to find the numerical results. You must provide the short solution, the solution for your problem. Don't write here, okay, if you write, for example, be two equal m plus 3, we will not accept. We will consider that you copy the general solution from someone else. So you must provide exactly your answer corresponding your m, and after that, the numerical result. And if you respect that rule, if you prepare well, okay, based on the end term review, I believe that you will have the high score. Good luck to you, and thank you for your attention.